Papu, Kanna, listen here. This is Ruby Teresa. Exercise 1.3, first problem. Verify the closure property for addition and multiplication. So, closure property for addition. Closure property for multiplication. You got to verify. For the rational numbers, minus 5 by 7 and 8 by 9. They have given two rational numbers. They have given two rational numbers. You have to verify what? Closure property for addition and closure property for multiplication. Before doing the problem, let us recall this. What is meant by closure property? That is, for any two rational numbers, A and B, for any two rational numbers, what is meant by rational number? It is in the form of P by Q. Where Q is not equal to 0 and P, Q belongs to integers. It is an element of integers. Do you follow? So, for any two rational numbers A and B, the sum A plus B is also a rational number. This is the closure property. In other words, how can you say? Any one of you? Very good. Sum of any two rational numbers is always a rational number. How? Sum of. Understand? Sum of any two rational numbers is always a rational number. Understand? They have specified that A and B. If they specified A and B, then they said that A plus B is also a rational number. But in general, how can you say that? Sum of two rational numbers is always a rational number. Same way for multiplication. Closure property for multiplication. For any two rational numbers, A and B, the product AB is also a rational number. How can you write this? Product of. Understand? Product of any two rational numbers is always a rational number. This is the easy way to remember. When they are asking closure property for addition or multiplication, this is easy sentence for you to say. Puridadakana? Easy are going to the sum of two rational numbers is always a rational number. Sum of a product of any two rational numbers is always a rational number. Sum of any two rational, sum of product of, only this is the difference. Sum of any two rational numbers is always a rational number. Product of any two rational numbers is always a rational number. It is not compulsory that you should take A, comma B. Any alphabet you can use. But Q is a representation of rational numbers. In general, you are specifying like this. Understand? If suppose X, Y, if you take, X plus Y belongs to Q. X, Y belongs to Q means XY belongs to Q. Understand? Now they have given two numbers. You can do the problem. What is it? Closure property for addition, let us take first. Therefore, minus 5 by 7 plus 8 by 9. If it is like terms, no problem. But here, what is it? Unlike terms. They are not like terms. So, to make this, how can you say that it is like terms or unlike terms? They are unlike terms. Very good. They don't have the same denominator. So, these two rational numbers are unlike terms. So, you have to take out the LCM. Otherwise, cross multiply. Least common multiple. Lowest common multiple. Expansion for LCM is. So, 7, 9. Understand? So, there is no common multiples here. So, cross multiply it is better to do. That is, minus 5 into 9 divided by 7 into 9 plus 8 into 7 divided by 9 into 7. Understand? That is 7 9s are 9 7s are. So you will get the same number. Isn't it? You will get the same number. That is least common multiply. That is cross multiplication. By doing the cross multiplication. Understand? So what is it? Minus 5 into 9. Either you can write like this, or if like this also you can write. Minus 5 into 9. Understand? So plus into minus, minus. 5 9s are 45. 9 5s are 45. 7 9s are 63. Next, plus 8 7s are 56. Divided by 63. Now you see, what is it? Very good, like terms. What you have to do? Add the numerator divided by the common denominator. Add the numerator. You write the numbers as it is. Divided by 63. This is nothing but what? 56 minus 45. 56 minus 45. Understand? From 56, otherwise if you want to change and write also, you can write 56 minus 45. Understand? 50 minus 45 is 5. 5 plus 6 is 11. 11 by 63. 11 by 63. 11 by 63 is nothing but the rational number. Isn't it? 11 by 63 is rational number. Minus 5 by 7 is also rational number. 8 by 9 is also rational number. Then 11 by 63 is also a rational number. It belongs to Q. Understand? 11. If you don't know to write it, it's symbol, you can write like this also. 11 by 63 is in Q. Understand? Do you follow or not? Therefore, closure property for addition holds good. Holds good. Closure property holds good for addition. Do you follow every one of you? Otherwise, it satisfies the closure property for addition. Understand? Do you follow? Or it is closed under addition. Or it is closed under addition. Understand? Otherwise, 11 by 63 is in Q. Already we wrote it. So it satisfies closure property. It satisfies closure property. Understand? Or A belongs to Q. B, instead of A, you can write the number itself. What is the number they have given? Tell me, one of you. Very good. Minus 5 by 7 belongs to Q, and 8 by 9 belongs to Q. Then, very good. 11 by 63 also belongs to Q. Understand? Do you follow? எப்படி வேணுமோ அப்படி எழுதுங்கடிக்கண்ணு. எப்படி வேணும்னாலும் நீ எழுதலாம். சரியா? புரியுதா புரியலையா? க்ளோஷர் ப்ராப்பர்ட்டி ஹோல்ஸ் குட் ஃபார் அடிஷன். இட் இஸ் க்ளோஸ்ட் அண்டர் அடிஷன். இட் சாட்டிஸ்ஃபைஸ் த க்ளோஷர் ப்ராப்பர்ட்டி. அதர்வைஸ் லைக் திஸ், எனி ஒன், நாட் ஆல் த ஃபோர். நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன் இஸ் வாட்? you have to check closure property for multiplication. So minus 5 by 7 into 8 by 9. So you have to multiply the corresponding numerators and denominators. That means what? Minus 5 into 8. Plus into minus, minus. 5 8s are 40. Divided by 7 9s are 63. You check whether it is in standard form. Yes. If there is any common multiple is there, you have to reduce it. But here it satisfies whether it belongs to rational number or not. Yes. Minus 5 by 7 belongs to Q. 8 by 9 belongs to Q. Then minus 40 by 63 also belongs to Q. Understand? Therefore, closure property for multiplication. Holds good. Understand? Otherwise, it is closed under multiplication. Under multiplication. That too, you have to say that multiplication of rational number, addition of rational number. Why I didn't specify rational number? It means they themselves, they have given. Understand? Now you are studying about rational numbers. Do you follow? Closed property for addition of rational numbers holds good. It is closed under addition of rational number. It satisfies the closure property of rational numbers. Do you follow or not? So any one of the way you can write. Puriyudadikanna inga enna eduthirukkorona LCM eduthirukkorom, least common multiple. The least common multiple ku enadhu inga common multiple illendradunala cross multiply panni eduthukitom seriyada kana minus 5 by 7 rational number, 8 by 9 um rational number, vandirukra answer um enadhu rational number da. Appa endha property satisfy agudhu? Closure property holds good for addition. Seriyadi kanna puriyuda puriyillaya? Adhe maari da multiplication. Minus 5 by 7 into 8 by 9. Minus 5 by 7 is the rational number. 8 by 9 is the rational number. This is multiply panni varakudiya product enadhu rational number. Tha. So closure property satisfies. Puriyudhungla? Righta? Okay va? Thank you.